On the 23rd of last month, the Chief Justice Alphonse Owindolo refused to recuse himself from the Robert Kyagulanyi election petition of 2021. However, Owindolo acknowledged that he had indeed been a lawyer to President Yoweri Museveni, who is also a respondent in the Kyagulanyi poll petition.
I'm giving you 2 minutes to wind up on the first ground, then we'll proceed on the other grounds.
The moment you say I'm remaining in the case, then there's no question as to whether the proceeding should stay or be expunged.
Then you abandon.
This compared lawyer Malema Birizi to petition the East African Court of Justice, appealing Owindolo's decision. He says that if the Chief Justice continues presiding over the Kyagulanyi poll petition, it is a clear indication that he will not dispense justice. He also seeks a clear explanation of why the Chief Justice could not step down from the matter.
I've just filed my reference in the South African Court of Justice challenging the refusal by Owindolo to recuse himself from Kyagulanyi Museveni case. That decision he made on 23rd last week. He said he is not recusing himself from the case, but that he will give the reasons later. Now, that is, to me, that is illegal. That contravenes the South African Committee Treaty, specifically Article 6 and 7. Those provisions are clear and also nullify all the decisions in respect of Kyagulanyi. Because Owindolo purely is a former lawyer of Museveni, he agrees with that. He has been meeting Museveni, and any common man cannot tell any reasonable person that Owindolo will be impartial or will be independent.
Mabirizi further filed another application in the Supreme Court registry where he wants court to halt all the proceedings in the petition until the East African Court makes a decision in his application.
And now applied for halting, for stay of proceedings now in the Kyagulanyi Museveni petition pending before the Supreme Court until the dispute in the East African Court of Justice is resolved, which dispute revolves around Owindolo's refusal to recuse. And that is premised on Article 38, sub-Article 2 of the South African Treaty, which says that when a matter has been referred to the court, the partner states shall restrain themselves from aggravating the situation, from making the situation worse. So Uganda has a duty, since the matter is before the court, Uganda has a duty to maintain the status quo as it is until the case is done.
Although a few days are remaining for court to deliver its verdict in the poll petition, Mabirizi seems unbothered. Instead, he insists he wants to unleash the injustices in the judiciary.
Come to the Supreme Court, because I've told you my second case is I've come to the Supreme Court telling them to stay the proceedings until the South African Court makes a decision. Because as I've been telling you, Article 38 tells every partner state to make sure that it does not aggravate the situation when a dispute is before the court. So that's why I've come to this court. Now, when they refuse, that's when I will think about going to them, telling them that, look.
The appeal decision was made on the 23rd of February by the Chief Justice himself. In the same petition, Male sought to have the court's refusal to grant Kyagulanyi more time to amend his petition quashed. I am Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news in Kampala.